Okay, now that you've decided that your shipping container lies horizontally, I'm going to show you how to put this on paper to be printed. On your project browser, so make sure you have both your properties in your project browser, you're going to scroll down and you're going to see the Sheets All. You're going to right click on Sheets All and you're going to go to New Sheet. Now, you have only one sheet selected. So you want to go in and load another. They're called title blocks, is what the sheets are called. So you want to go in and click load. This is how you're going to load your horizontal sheet. Click on computer. And we're going to click that GTT, the G drive. Double click that. And then we are in Revit, so double click Revit. And then here are your two sheets. Yours is a horizontal layout, so you want to click the horizontal title block. Double click that, and now it loads in this, back to this screen. So here's your horizontal. So make sure it's highlighted, and then click OK. Now your house disappears, and it gives you this sheet, which is fine. Here's how you get your shipping container onto this title block. Come back up here underneath floor plans, level one. You're going to left click and drag. As soon as you start to drag, your mouse turns into arrows with the plus. So drag it over, and then when it's on your paper, you want to release your mouse. So unclick, and you'll see a box. I'm still moving my mouse. I'm not clicked anything. You're going to have to click again to get it to stay. Now, this looks really small on my paper. You can ignore this black line, but that looks really small on my paper. How you increase the size is over here under your properties browser is a view scale. So click this arrow, and I'm going to change mine to a fourth. The higher up you go, the larger it is. So I'm going to change mine to a fourth of an inch, and then click apply. And again, you're going to have to move this. It's okay. And that's about right. You can try the next one and see. Yours is probably all going to be just a little bit different. But that's pretty close. You don't want it too big where it overlaps. You don't want it too small where you can't see anything. When you're finished, when you're finished, if you scroll in, you can click on these blue boxes and change the name. So you're going to change the checker. You're going to put down your name and then the project name. If you double click, you can type in there. You're going to name it shipping container. Floor view. And then just click off and it'll stay. And I'm just scrolling in and out with my mouse to zoom. Now I'm ready to print this, so I'm going to click the R and click the arrow next to print, and I'm going to go to print preview. Now that looks pretty good. You can see my name and shipping containers there. If it looks okay, you can go ahead and click print, and you want to make sure it's the PLTW one, MSDC2/MSPLTW. Make sure it says that printer, and then hit OK. And then go get it off the printer. Now, the other one that you have to print is a 3D view. To print your 3D view, you're going to use your project browser again. Scroll down to where it says Sheets. Hit the plus next to that. You'll have this unnamed sheet that's underneath here with a plus next to it. Hit that plus next to there. And this is what is on that sheet, your floor plan level one. So click on it, so it's blue, left click. And then you're going to right click. So make sure it's blue, then right click. And you're going to click the remove from sheet. We don't want this floor plan on our sheet anymore. So click remove from sheet. And then it goes away. Our sheet's still there. Still says my name, still says shipping container. Now we're going to come up here to underneath your 3D view, click the plus, and try and get just the plain 3D view. Again, to put it on your sheet, you're going to left click and drag. And I know I'm dragging because my mouse is turned into the arrows with the plus, and put it on your paper. It is this direction because that's the last time I looked at it. So if it needs to be rotated the other direction, just hit delete, right click and delete it. You can go back to your 3D view, hit your home button so it sits the correct direction, and then go back to your sheet. There's my sheet. Again, left click, drag it over, put on there. Again, that's pretty small, so let's change our size. Remember, go up, it gets bigger. And that's pretty good. The other thing we need to change is down here, this isn't our floor view anymore. Change the floor to 3D view. You also shouldn't have it in the color format. You should change the color. If you come back down here, see if I can get mine to change. Just change it to hidden lines. When you click back on your paper, it should update it for you. So you want this to print out, you'll be able to see it a lot better. Then click your R, print preview. If it all looks good, hit the print. Again, make sure it says the right printer and click OK.